of you are asking, what is Shiloh? So let us listen carefully and be blessed. What is Shiloh? One may ask, what is Shiloh? Is Shiloh a human being? Shiloh. 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 How many times should I call you Shiloh? Oh. Okay, now I know that according to Judges chapter 21 verse 19, the Bible says Shiloh was a city in ancient Israel, situated north of Bethel and south of Shechem in the hill country of Ephraim. The Bible also describes Shiloh as an assembly place for the people of Israel from the time of Joshua. The word Shiloh appears 33 times in the Old Testament. But what about Shiloh that they were talking about? Oh, okay. The Shiloh of Winners Chapel is an annual prophetic gathering for all the winners worldwide. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
This annual gathering was started in 1999. Oh, that means this year Shiloh is the 22nd. And it will begin on the 7th of December, that is next Tuesday, up to the 12th of December 2021, with the theme More Than a Conqueror, and it is taken from the book of Romans, chapter 8, verse 37. More than a conqueror? Yes. More than a conqueror, meaning we are winning without fighting any battle. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. The enemy is already scared of us, so we just go and conquer territories.
Praise the Lord.
But what should we expect at Shiloh? One should prepare to meet with God at Shiloh. In the book of Amos, chapter 4, verse 12, says, prepare to meet with your God. Because Shiloh is the mountain of divine encounters, where God has prepared everything ready for us by his word. Luke, chapter 14, 17, says, all things are ready. Matthew 22, 11 to 12, says, talks about the man who came with a garment which was not meant for the wedding banquet and was thrown out. Therefore, prepare yourself and prepare your garments. Proverbs 16:1 says, the preparation of the heart belongs to man, but the answer of the tongue belongs to our God. Therefore, preparation is vital so that we don't come to this holy mountain carelessly. We cannot maximize the impact of Shiloh without adequate preparation. My brother, my sister, please prepare your heart. Repent of anything that will defile you. Clean up with God, because our God is a holy God. And if we are going to climb that mountain of holiness, we must be holy, worthy, and acceptable. Exodus 10, Exodus 19 says, and the Lord said to Moses, go to the people and sanctify them today and tomorrow, and let them wash their clothes. Not only their clothes they wash, but they also prepare their hearts. At Shiloh, everything speaks, but not everybody hears. Therefore, prepare yourself to hear. Through the praise, through the worship, through the testimonies, and through the word encounter. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Even through the specialized classes, God will give you your own miracles.
Amen.
Do you want an encounter this year at Shiloh?
Yes.
Do you want an encounter this year at Shiloh?
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Come to Shiloh 2021 at Winners Chapel of Tobin.
Amen.
We meet you there.
Amen.
Let me lift up the voice and appreciate God. Worship Him. Magnify Him. Thank you. Keep up His calling to us. Thank you.
Thank you. can deceive a mother, deceive people. You can look onto and say, maybe your father tells you, I will do this for you, I will do that for you. But when they are no longer there, you just discover that in life, you don't have any other person other than God. Praise the Lord. There's no one like God in your life, and there's no one like God in my life. Praise the Lord. So no matter what it is, I'd like you to know that God is ever faithful. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for this service. We give you glory. We thank you for today. Thank you for what you are going to do in this crescendo encounter service, which is the last. And we give you the glory. Holy Spirit, take over this service. Send your word to your people. Confirm your word. Holy Ghost, we are not brought us to bless us. We are brought us to do a new thing in our lives.
Amen.
Holy Spirit, thank you, because today there shall be signs, wonders, miracles, healings, and deliverances in the name of Jesus. And at the end of the day, the glory shall be ascribed unto your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Hallelujah. Every time that the neighbor, you are moving forward. Tell that your neighbor, God is changing your story. Tell that your neighbor, God will surprise you. Tell that your neighbor, I am standing by faith to tell you from today, you will succeed. You shall be great. My neighbor, God will give you a testimony. In Jesus' mighty name. Tell that your neighbor, neighbor, look at me very well. Very, very soon, you will celebrate me because of what God will do in my life. Tell that your neighbor, I love you, my neighbor. In Jesus' mighty name. Shiloh 2021, and more than a conqueror, put some hands together for Jesus and please be seated in God's presence. Amen. I welcome you on behalf of God to church this morning. Today is our last Shiloh encounter service. Next Sunday is going to be our anointing service. Usually before Shiloh commences, the Sunday before Shiloh is usually our anointing service. So next Sunday is anointing service. Take note of that and prepare to be a part of that service in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Understanding the wonders of Thanksgiving is our topic. We're looking at part 4, section 1. In this service, understanding the wonders of Thanksgiving. We have been told when the month began that when we give God thanks for what He has done, and we are reminding Him of what remains, when you thank God for what He has done, you are reminding God of what remains. So it's your responsibility to thank Him for what He has done, and it is His responsibility to do what remains for you. So, one is a product of the other. Thanking Him for what He has done, or doing what remains, is a product of thanking God for what He has done. For God to do what remains in your life is a product of your thanking Him for whatever He has done in your life. And you know, our lives are full of God's benefits, God's goodness, God's favor. If you look at Psalm 116 and verse 12, hear what David said there. Psalm 116 and verse 12. David, the poetic, the man who knows how to move God. He said, what shall I render unto the Lord? Verse 12. Psalm 116, verse 12. He said, what shall I render unto the Lord for all His benefits towards me? What shall I render? What can I give to God for all His benefits towards me? What is it that you and I can give to him? Is it money? Does he need that money? No. Even though we have to give for his work to move on. He said, what shall I render unto the Lord for all his benefits towards me? Our lives are full of the benefits of God. And in verse 17, he said, I will offer to thee the sacrifice of thanksgiving, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. He said, I will offer unto God the sacrifice of thanksgiving, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. So you and I are meant to offer unto God the sacrifices of thanksgiving. In Psalm 146 and verse 1 and 2, he said, praise ye the Lord. He said, praise the Lord, O my soul. Praise the Lord, O my soul. You know, in Psalm 103, he said, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. He said, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. He said, who forgiveth all my iniquities, and who redeemeth my life from destruction, and crowneth me with loving kindness and tender mercies. So in verse 2 of Psalm 146, he said, while I live, I will praise the Lord. Not while I have money, or not while I get a job, or not while I am healthy. While I live, while I have breath, I will praise the Lord. He said, I will sing praises unto my God while I have my being. So once you are alive, the Bible said, every living soul must praise the Lord. He said, because a living dog is better than a dead lion. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If you have a shop, you are better than somebody who is thinking of starting a business. So you say, my business is not working. My shop is almost gone. Thank God you have a shop. You are better than the one who has not started. You are better than the one who cannot even start, even though he wants to start. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, we have always told you, wherever you are today, you are better than a million people. If they bring the people, you are better than you start and get God. Are you hearing what I'm saying? If you want to know, go to the hospital, intensive care, where they hang the leg of some people, where they tell you, this man has been on this position for the past 2 years. He cannot change one position. Sometimes you look at that part of the body, it's rotten. They just move it up, clean it, they leave it there. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But you and I are here, healthy, living well, living sound. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And somebody says, because it looks as if I may not have money to send to my people this year. What about the one you sent to them last year? If you didn't have this year, God wants to teach you and your people a lesson. That is why. Praise the Lord. So relax yourself and don't kill yourself. And just know that God will never be faithful to you. If you don't have money to send to your people in December, it is because of what God is planning for you in January. So all you need to do is to thank him for your present situation so that he can change it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, we hear a man of things, they say things are quite tough now out there. Things are tough. But I'd like you to know something. God will never forget his own.
Amen.
David said, I have been young and now I am old. I have never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed doing what? Begging for bread. You will never beg for bread because you are the seed of God.
Amen.
You will never beg for bread because you are the child of God.
Amen.
Are you hearing what I'm saying? So no matter what the economy is saying, if you can just lift up your voice, if you can appreciate him from the depth of your heart, you can never beg for bread. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, when we give God thanks for what he has done, we remind him of what remains. When you thank God for what he has done, it means you are showing gratitude to God. It means you are grateful for that thing he has done in your life. It means you appreciate the Lord for his good works in your life. And when God knows that you know how to appreciate him, then he will keep blessing you more and more and more. Amen. The reason why God has not blessed us to the level that he wants to bless us is because a lot of us do not know how to appreciate the Lord. You know how to play football. You know how to do your exercise. You know how to write your account, how to do a lot of other things. I remember those days when I was working in the account, even in the dream, you are doing accounts. Has it happened to you as an accountant? In those days when I was in the account section, in the dream, I'm counting money. Praise the Lord. You know how to do it. It's in you, it's part of you. It is in your DNA. You are in it. That thing is inside of you. If gratitude can be in your life like that, you will never lack the blessings of God. So thanksgiving secures answers for our prayers. Secures answers for our prayers. It brings speedy answers to your prayers. When you are a thanksgiver, every time you pray, because you are a thanksgiver, there is always a speedy response to your prayer. If you are not a thanksgiver, God will find it difficult to respond to your prayer. Now listen to me. God is not different from us in so many ways. The way man is, that is how God is. When you do something for someone and you neglect that act and it doesn't show appreciation, as a man, you don't feel moved to do more. Am I communicating? That's how God is. He created us in his image and in his likeness. That's why when you are not a thanksgiver, you are in bondage. Not just in the bondage of God, but in the bondage of men. You say, what is this? And that is it. And if you remain like that, and what is it under God? Praise the Lord. Have you asked your mates that are not doing anything? Now listen to me. If you want to know how God has been merciful to you, go around Juba during the day. You will see a lot of more qualified young people who are not doing anything. Listen to me. Sometimes you talk to some people, you ask them anything today, they tell you for the past 3 days, I'm not taking anything. Not that they don't want to eat, but that is your life as Christian. You are better than them, so you should thank God for where you are. The Bible said in Exodus 15, verse 11, he said, who is like unto thee, O Lord? Who is like unto thee? He said, glorious in holiness, fearful in praises, and doing wonders. I told you last Sunday, anytime you pray, what you should receive is wonders. But what is that our wonder most of the time? It's not the devil, it's not the demon, it's our attitude of ingratitude. You are not grateful to the God that gave you that little thing, and you want a big thing from him. The Bible said our God is a righteous God. Who is a righteous person? The one that does what is right. The one that sees what is wrong and is not pleased. And ingratitude is wrong. So when you are ungrateful, God moves away from you. That is righteousness. It's not wickedness. You say, that man, because I didn't do anything, he didn't give me anything again. Yes, it's you who is wicked, not the man. Praise the Lord. It's you who should change, not the man. Because the man has emotions. He doesn't want to be taken for granted. So he locates somebody and says, this one didn't appreciate. Let me bless this one. Maybe this one will appreciate. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Your heavens are declared open in Jesus.
Amen.
I said your heavens are declared open in the name of Jesus. So, thanksgiving is a bailout of prayers or praying without answers. A lot of people pray, no answer. They are like, it's like they're in jail. It's like the devil has jailed them. The devil has put them in the cage. When they pray, it looks as if their prayer returns back to them. The thanksgiving is the bailout of a life of praying without an answer. So when you get up today, give God a quality thanks. Appreciate Him for what He has done in your life. So, you are either toiling in prayers or prevailing in prayers. God does not want us to toil in prayers. Because He's your Father and He's my Father. Just because I'm talking to you now, that is how God wants us to communicate. There shouldn't be barriers because He's our good God. The Bible says our God is good. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Why are the barriers so sophisticated? It looks as if God is so far. I have been praying and God is not answering me. Listen to me. A man who is ungrateful is a brother to the waster. Is a brother to the covetous. Most of the time, the reason why people do not appreciate little acts of God in their lives is because they are greedy. They want everything. Even the one you have, they want to collect it. He said, why did you give that one a car? You gave me one car, you gave me one car. Why shouldn't he be fed? They are greedy. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So don't be greedy. Don't look at what he has not done. Look at the things he has done. Amen.
Amen.
I remember when I was young, years ago, I wouldn't have had one eye. As little children, we went to fresh water. You know those days, no pipe on water. When it comes once in a while, when it comes in my place, you will see buckets from east to west. Did it happen in your village?
Yes, sir.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So we used to go to the well to draw water. God is faithful. He said, if I formed in the belly, I knew you. He said, the numbers of your head, I know them. One will not be missing without his agreement. So we went to fetch water. I put water on my head, I was coming. And a young man, in those days, there was this kind of rock, I don't know how they do it, they put an iron pin inside, and they shoot it. I was holding water on my head, I was a young boy, and this guy shot that arrow. And the arrow came and landed here. Can you imagine? If I tell you it has been a long time that God has been delivering me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Those days I was not, of course, as a child of, as a little boy, you don't know God. You go to church, you don't even know what God is all about. But as little as that, God preserved my eyes.
Amen.
Now, the only escape was because I blinked. If I had not blinked, I would have lost my eyes. And what can we do to him? Nothing. He's a young boy. Would you take him to jail? No. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So, can you rewind back to those things that God has done for you? And sit down and congratulate. You can even write yourself a congratulation letter. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? Because some of you are waiting for somebody to congratulate you. When he prayed 3 days ago, last month or this month, a young boy, 17 years old, they said he died of diabetes. Is it diabetes or high blood pressure? And I said, what is the meaning of this? In those days, this kind of diseases are meant for old people. 70 years, 80 years. A young boy was about 17 years old. The devil located him and brought him out of this world. They have been doing all sorts of things, and the devil has not been able to pluck you out. Is it your righteousness? No. Is it because you are good? No. man is like a filthy rag before me. Now, somebody may say, I'm a holy man. What about when you were not holy? And God preserved you. Went to Jesus. Say, Father, thank you. Because you are good to me.
Because you are good to
me. Psalm 116 and verse 17. Psalm 116 and verse 17. I've read it before. Philippians 4, 6 and Colossians 4, 2. Philippians 4, 6. Let me read that scripture. Philippians 4, 6. He said, be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God. Listen to me. Drop that body from your heart, out of your heart. Drop it. In case you came with the body, drop it. Drop it now. Don't come back home with it. A body in your heart is a pledge for your life. Are you listening to what I'm saying?
Yes.
When there's a body in your heart, that body will cage you. So drop it. Tell the devil, I drop it now. I'm not going back home with it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Colossians chapter 4, verse 2. Is that continue in prayer and walk in the soul with what? You are praying, but are you thanking the Lord? Number three, thanksgiving secures fulfillment of prophecy among others. So, a genuine thanksgiver can believe in anything like Abraham. The reason why you don't believe in the report and the prophecies of God is because you are not a genuine thanksgiver. You are not. If you are, you can believe everything. Abraham believed everything God told him. God told him, I'll give you a child. I'll make you the father of nations. And as at that time, Abraham had no child. But the Bible said Abraham believed in God. So, what is it that you can believe in God for? The reason why a lot of us do not believe in God, we don't even know the scriptures. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
A genuine thanksgiver will believe in anything. In this kingdom, what you believe is what you experience. The body of Sarah was dead. Or the womb of Sarah was dead. The body of Abraham had died. But the faith of Abraham was strong. The Bible said he was strong in faith. You can take down that contract before the end of this year. Say it loud by your name if I'm talking to you. You think our God is in one God? I told you how the devil took my car on Friday. What I have in the account is not up to 10,000 naira of Nigerian money. On Sunday, God gave me another car. Now listen, that morning, when I was entering the church, I saw the car parked. Something told me, that is your car. Are you crazy? Are you hearing what I'm saying? And after the service, they called me, they said, Pastor Abuna, that is your time. But you know what? In the midst of that trial, because it was a trial, my wife was there, my family was in the vehicle, in the town. Not that, because before then, we were having dreams of attacks. That the devil was knocking on the door of the family to clear the land. And suddenly it happened. I was in the office and I was called upon. I never complained one bit. No word of complaint came out of my mouth. I was happy that everyone in the title was preserved. So you can know the money the devil is. It was in the town. Which raised in a woman running in town. And the fire butchered. And she put her leg on the plate. And tagged it, left the ground, began to somersault in the head. Left one side of the road and landed on the other side of the road. When they came out, every one of I have enrolled you in the list of checkers. So it's Friday, Saturday, Sunday, we checked to church. Use Kekena Pek. What do they call it now? Lash to church. 3 days. Sunday, Saturday, and what? Sunday. On the third day, he did what? He rose again. Hallelujah! The third day, he gave us a car without anything in their car. They will never murmur. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So, when your faith is not barren, anything around you that may be barren will soon be fruitful. Are you hearing what I'm saying? All you need to do is to ensure that your faith is not what? Barren. I went to sports scholarship. When I got born again in those days, got admission, and I came to tell my father, got an admission, the first thing that came out of his mouth, I don't have money. So I come back. I started doing evangelism. One day in the afternoon, I was sleeping in our tenant's house room, sleeping during the day. And I had a revelation. I saw a group of people talking about me. That young man would want to help him. And as I woke up from that dream, my father said for me, he said, somebody sent for me from Lagos that he wants to be responsible for my education. Now, I was in school. By the reason of that encounter, I was helping others by what was coming into my
life.
When I told him that I gained admission, he said, I don't have money. But I didn't cry. I came up with an idea. I said, even if I don't have a father, I will succeed. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
If you know the God you have, you will not doubt him. You will not be shaking like a butterfly. You will not be running around like a mosquito. You will settle down in the house of God until your testimony comes. The Bible says, in the what? In the court of our God. Stop running and I'll build your faith. I'm building my faith. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes.
Hallelujah. So we are told that every genuine giving will always result in praise. And we told you that one of the ways to praise God is to sing and to dance. Thanksgiving is a vital mystery behind the growth of the church. So when we are thanking God, the church grows. Acts 2:47 and Jeremiah 30:19. Thanksgiving preserves, presents, and multiplies our blessings. Malachi chapter 2:1-3. Thanksgiving preserves, it perfects, and it multiplies our blessings. He said, if you do not get to have to give me thanks, then I will cause your blessings. So, when you are thanksgiving, God blesses you. He gives the blessings, and he multiplies the blessings. Ecclesiastes 3:14. He said, whatsoever the Lord doeth, it shall be forever. Nobody can change it. The devil cannot change it. The demons cannot change it. Your boss cannot change it. Your father cannot change it. Your mother cannot change it. Your in-laws cannot do what? Change what God has done what? Done. Hallelujah. God is helping you. Say it louder, you man. God will settle you. 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 My story will change in the name of Jesus. Proverbs 10:22. Is that a blessing?
in Maker rich and after no soul. So when God blesses you, He makes you rich. So thank you. Thanksgiving is a spiritual channel for the realization of our glorious destiny. If you want to realize your glorious destiny, like Job, in Job chapter 1, 18 to 22, and Job chapter 2, 7 to 10, Job was a big man. He lost everything. His children died. And Job said, Job didn't complain. That's Job chapter 1, 18 to 22. Go to Job chapter 1. Let me just be something from there. Move on. Let me tell you. Don't fall. I cannot tell you. He saves me and washes me with His blood. So I can shout hallelujah. I can shout hallelujah. I can shout praise the Lord. So I will shout hallelujah. I will shout hallelujah. I will shout. The devil took everything that Job had. In chapter 2, the devil afflicted Job in some parts. And he took a potsherd and was cutting his body. And the beautiful wife who wanted to kill Job and marry another woman came and said, come, curse God and die. And Job said, don't worry, I won't curse God. If you want to die, die, because I'll be well. When I get well, I'll marry a new wife. And Job told her, he said, why are you talking like a foolish woman? Why are you behaving like a foolish woman? I have taught you the way of the Lord. How do you talk in your place of business? Everything, Marquess. They call you, how are you?
God does not handle your matter with left hand. He handles your matter with what?
memory of God is not short. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ask him, sir, how many hair on my head? He will tell you. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Praise the Lord. So, if Rahab can fulfill his destiny, you can fulfill your destiny. So, for your life to appreciate, you need to keep appreciating God. Appreciate the words of God in your life. Number three, or number four, thanksgiving facilitates access to revelation. It facilitates access to the mind of God. 2 Kings 3:15, the prophet, he said, bring me a mystery. And as the mystery was praying, the hand of God rested upon him. And he was able to know what to do. If you look at Psalm 16, verse 11, he said, thou will lead me in the path of life. In thy presence is fullness of joy. At the right hand are pleasures forevermore. So Jesus always knew what to do because he was a thanksgiver. When you're a thanksgiver, anytime you take your Bible to read, God reveals secrets to you. Thanksgiving puts you on top of any situation because you'll always know what to do from his word by revelation. Revelation makes you talk differently. It makes you think differently. It makes you act differently. You cannot fulfill your destiny without revelation. So you need revelation. That's why you need to be joyful.
You are the miracle working.
like you to lift up your hands and appreciate God. Just give him the glory. Remember all his benefits in your life and thank him. Worship him. Any light worship song that you can do? Just worship the Lord. Just worship him. Thank him. For everything he has done for you from January to now. Thank him and thank him and thank him. Thank him. Thank him for your business. Thank him for your family. Thank him for all the profits you have seen. It doesn't matter what is happening in November. Thank him for what happened in January. January was good for you. February was good for you. Even though this may not be the way you want them now. Thank him for the thank him for what he ever did in your life. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him. Rame Shata. Lord, we thank you. We bless you. We give you glory. We give you praise. I thank you for my health, for my body, for my life, for my family. I give you glory. I give you praise. I worship you, Lord. I appreciate you. There's no one like you, oh God. Lord, thank you. It doesn't matter what I'm lost. Because of you, that's why I'm not lost everything. Thank you, Father.
Why those who want to give their life to Christ and coming out will be taking our Priscilla expectation prayer to raise the last week Priscilla service. You'll be asking for whatever you want to do in your life, either to be on the first Shiloh or in Shiloh. Hallelujah. You know you are there, you are not born again. You know that Jesus is not in your life. You are not living well, you are not living right, you are still living in sin. You are living in fornication, doing the things you shouldn't do. And you want to say, Jesus, come into my life. I want to give my life to you. I want to surrender to you. I'd like you to lift up your hand wherever you are. You want to surrender to Jesus. Come, darling. Come. Come. If you are, come, even if you didn't lift up your hand, you want to give your life to Jesus, come to the front so we'll pray for you. Please, come. Why are you singing? Come if you are coming quickly. We'll be singing for you as you come.
To Jesus, blessed Savior, I surrender all.
I surrender.
I surrender all.
I surrender.
I surrender all.
Into my life, come into my heart. Jesus, I accept you as my Lord and my Savior. Forgive me all my sins. Write my name in the book of life. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. Thank you, Father, for washing me with the blood of your Son. From today, I am born again. I'm a child of God in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Before then, we're going to be praying a Priscilla expectation prayer. You will be left. Service, we'd like you to come to the front and join us as beloved brethren.
Today is the first time for your prayer with us in this service. Please come here so that we can recognize you. Today is your first time of praying with us. You are welcome to Lawrence. You are welcome to Winners Chapel International, Juba, South Sudan. Is any of you here new? You are new? You pray here for the first time? It's your first time. First time for everybody. You're welcome. God bless you. In the name of Jesus. You're welcome to Winners Chapel International, Juba, South Sudan, the home of signs and wonders, where God does great, great things in the lives of his people. We love you and we say welcome in Jesus' mighty name. God bless you. God will give you your heart desire. God will be faithful to you. He will show you blessings. He will bless you. He will protect you. We want to make this church a church. We're coming here every Sunday to come and pray that you came here today. God has blessed you. Come next Sunday again. And God will keep blessing you and changing your level. We are called Winners Chapel. And this is the only Winners Church in Juba by the grace of God. A whole Sunday service presently, though we have it right in Sherikat, they also praise on Sunday, but by the grace of God in Juba and its environment, this is the only Winners Church, and you're welcome. We love you and we appreciate your coming. Next Sunday, join us again. My name is Pastor Victor Iyogun, by the grace of God. I'm the senior pastor, I'm the national pastor. If you want to meet with me either on Tuesday or Thursday, you're free to come around. God bless you. In Jesus' mighty name. Next Sunday is an appointing service. It is called Pre-Shiloh Anointing Service. Shiloh is our annual event. It's starting on Tuesday of next week. So you can join us. It's an annual event where the prophet over this commission will be praying over us, ministering to us, blessing us, and other powerful men of God. And they will be here connecting to Canaan land by the grace of God. So I'd like you to join us, and the God of Shiloh will meet you at the point of the gates in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Today is our Thanksgiving service. I'd like you to bring up your Thanksgiving offering. Please, you're welcome. It's good to you. While we celebrate God for his good acts all through the month of November 2021. Bring out your Thanksgiving offering, your late offering, your giving it, your tithe. Bring them out so that we can celebrate this good God. They are blessed in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Quran.
Thank you.
In my bed, there's people here. This one and death. Death is coming. So, Oda saw Goliath as death, but he saw Goliath as a gate. You know why? It's a thanksgiving. Revelation. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So, if when you refuse to be overwhelmed, you will definitely what? Overcome. Praise God.
Amen.
God is here. These things I'm telling you, I didn't read from any book. God spoke them to me one after the other to tell me. That will tell you that God is in our midst. Are you getting what I'm saying? Huh?
Yeah.
Every this morning I was listening to one message by the side Papa was preaching. And one of the things I wrote down, I think in the second service, to preach in the second service, I have Papa saying this on the tape. And I said, Victor, you are connected.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Praise God.
Amen.
So please, all these things, God, they are for you. When you refuse to be overwhelmed by your challenge, you will definitely do what?
Overcome.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when the devil wants to overwhelm you, just get a tape and begin to dance. You dance a funny dance so that the devil will go crazy. Is that what you can do? I didn't say, no, this man is not a this one kind of a Christian in this rich. Let's leave him alone. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Well, the Shiloh rally is this Saturday. And we are encouraging you to please come and join us on Saturday. Rally is going to be from 7.